join us here today at Boddington Reservoir in Northamptonshire. It's a venue that is full of carp in the £5 to £20 region, but the one problem at this time of year is they don't like to come near the bank. So that means long-range feeder fishing is the name of the game. Now, as someone who usually fishes small commercials that may be 20, 30, 40 yard chucks, this is a little bit out of my game. But we've got a man that's going to teach me a few things as we test a couple of rods. How are you doing?
Well, I think you're a little bit generous there, but no, I've spent a little bit of time teaching myself how to chuck rods like this, where we've got two rods on test today. We have a Guru A-Class 13-foot feeder rod. Now this, you can pick these up for under £100.
I've got the Free Spirit highest power feeder 13-foot. Now this is over £400. Two different price brackets, two brilliant rods from what we're told, but they're obviously going to have very different attributes. So I think it's time to tackle up and see what we can do with them.
Well, for anyone who hasn't seen distant sticks before, basically, as the name implies, two sticks in the ground. We've got a 2.5 metre piece of rope between them. So one full lap of the two sticks is 5 metres. So very quick and easy way of finding out what distance we've been casting. Starting off with the A-class rod, we've got a loaded Guru hybrid feeder, 45 gram one. We've got the same clip-ons, 107.5 metres. Let's see how far off we are.
Give it some
clip.
Give it some. It's hard to see the actual action in such fast pace. That clips. I heard it twang.
That hit the clip, but as it hit the water. But look at the slack on that, though.
Still impressive cast.
Well, the A-class, which was doing 107 metres with the bomb, drop it down to a feeder, it was still doing over 100. So that's really good for obviously a rod of that price range.
This
Let's
should fly.
See what the rod doing over four times the price can do.
I'm expecting a convincing clink on the clip. Oh, that felt good. That sounded good. Oh, that was still travelling. That was still travelling.
That proper hit the clip. That proper hit the clip.
That was travelling.
That was 107. So that's quite interesting. On the cheaper rod, we dropped probably 10 metres, didn't we?
I reckon so.
By putting a feeder on. This more expensive rod, it made very little difference. And bearing in mind, both of us, it takes a while to get used to a rod. I still feel like I'm holding back a little bit. You're a little bit concerned at going all out. So I'd say it's probably got even more in it still. Well, we settled ourselves down in the early 100s, both clipped up at 65 metres. So, okay, we're sat in the same peg, so we're very close together, but we've fanned out. I'm casting rod over that way. Tone's casting rod over that way, so we've found our own water. Particularly this kind of year, it's not a venue where you're going to be casting all the time. It's very much almost like dobbing with a feeder, really. You're just putting a loaded feeder in the sort of area where you're going to catch fish, and then you're waiting. So first off, we're going to give it 20 minutes. If we don't get a fish after 20 minutes, we're just going to unclip and slowly start creeping a little bit further out into the lake. And hopefully, we'll find a few fish. But whilst we're waiting for a bite, let's talk a little bit about the gear we're using. So although the rod is obviously very important, the reel needs to be dead right as well. We're using Shimano Ultegra reels. They're 5,500 in size. And, you know, they're just well suited, a good workhorse reel for this kind of fishing and the sort of distances we're looking at casting. The line we've got on these is £5 Pulse Pro. So I've personally tried a number of different lines for casting reel distances, and although I think £6 line is far kind of safer, you know, if you're casting 60, 70, 80 metres, when you're looking at getting more like 100, which hopefully we will be a little bit later, a real thin line definitely gets you extra metres. It's not just a thin line, it's a very smooth line as well, the Pulse Pro. So to cast off, we've both got a shock leader of £12 Daiwa Tournament ST. Now this is a real strong, robust line. We've got two rod lengths of that, which allows you to put as much effort as you want into the cast, the line's not going to break. But once those two rod lengths of line have peeled off the reel, you've got that real thin Pulse Pro that's just going to resistance-free glide off the reel and keep the feeder going to maximum distance. On the business end again, we've got Guru hybrid feeders. Like, we're both starting off on a 45 gram one. Bait wise, we've got some Ringers Slims in yellow. And after speaking to a number of locals here, like, it's gone out of fashion a little bit. We used to use goo and stuff like that on the feeders. What seems to be all the rage at the minute is Ringers Caramel FX Glaze. We've both had a cast each without that on. If we don't get a bite, we'll try a little bit further out and we'll try a little bit of glaze every now and again, see if that makes a difference.
So, second cast of the day, pick the rod up and we're in.
Oh, it's important to mention the cast as well. Like, the first cast was 20 minutes each.
Yeah.
Neither of us had a bite. So we both paid off an extra 5 metres. So we're then clipped up at 70.
And the timing of it as well.
Yeah, and that was after 22 minutes.
It's got a nice action with it. I feel like I've got power. There's some snags to me right here. So we're going to find out in a minute.
Said it were a big one.
I know, I was gonna say, I think I've got a Boddington's pup. Hey!
What's that? What's 8? 10?
I'll tell you what, there's not many venues where you can come and call them pups, is there? But that's gotta be 8 to 10 pounds. So we'll get the hook out and we'll take a closer look. There's the result. 7, 8, 9 pounds, an absolute chunk. And the A-class has done its job. Delivered it out there with ease, 70 metres of playing action. Had all the power it needed, a bit of finesse in the end, when it tried to go into the snags at the end, had the power to do that. And ultimately, what do you want a rod to do? You want it to put the rig in place, and you want it to get the fish in? Job done.
And it is. Yeah. A lot of power, that fish. No, I'm really enjoying this rod. Interesting about it, you know, it's a two-piece rod. 13 foot long, but two pieces. Free Spirit have decided they can get a better action at the rod, better performance by having a 13 foot two-piece, which trickier to fit into a ready rod bag, but it's when you get a rod like this.
When you get to, when you get onto the price range further up, what you're getting is you've got the blend of power and cushion there is amazing.
Yeah.
You've got one fish on here. This could be your only fish of the day. You can't, you know, it can't just be a broom handle that sculls it in. It's got to have some give. And those lunges you're talking about, you can see every nod in that tip. You can see that nice action coming through. Yeah, at the end of the day, if you want to boss it down at the business end, you know, with the butt end, you've got the power.
Yeah, your number one priority with a distance rod has to be it can cast the distance.
Yeah.
Number two is the fish playing action. It doesn't matter how good the fish playing action is, if the rod can't cast the distance in the first place, it's useless. It's not a distance rod then, is it?
Absolutely. So that brings to an end a really enjoyable day. And it's fair to say that, from my perspective, the rod that I've had the most use the most today, the A-class, this isn't the sort of fishing I am going to do loads of. You know, I've had some great pointers off Dan today. He's helped show me that this is not an impossible style of fishing. Anyone can go out and do it if you get the right kit. And if you're the sort of person that may come somewhere like Boddington's, Barston, Meadowlands, every now and then, and have to chuck a bit, this is probably going to be the rod for you. It'll reach the distance, it'll get the fish in, and for 70 quid, you can't argue. What about yours, Dan?
Well, absolutely stunning. I knew it was going to be a good rod, obviously, by looking at the price, but I'm actually blown away as to how good it was. So over the years, I've tested a number of different rods as part of the job, and it's surprising how many rods out there are capable of reaching 100 metres plus. But I have to say, that is probably the easiest rod to reach 100 metres that I've ever fished with. And so we were hitting 107 metres up there with it, with a loaded feeder. It felt like it had more.
And whether, like I say, whether it's something you want to do all the time and you want to shell out a load of money or something like that, or something you do less frequently, something like this. But ultimately, they both cast to the spot, they both get the fish in, and then it's down to the attributes to what you want.
Absolutely.